That could actually happen.
Well, the Tom Kench has been locked in, so Papa, I actually have no idea. Looks like it will be bang on the Soraka as Blank.
The reason why it...
Whoa!
Oh, big hook right. Actually lands all in the right. Binds right there.
He's
yeah,
dead.
Straight up Zealot epic first blood. Going over to BDD on the Morgana in the bottom lane. Oh my god.
The Rage Blade would be something.
Well, Blank going to throw out the ultimate and lands it onto Khan. They're going to secure it this time around, I have a feeling, as Tal gets bopped back. Takes a little while, but he's got the ult this time, and they'll bring the hammer down and finally secure that kill.
A bit of catharsis.
Yeah. A fair bit of wave clear in this one, but lands another bind. There's the hook to follow it up as Effort. He's in trouble, burning down from the ignite as the ultimate comes out from Gorilla. They're looking for the knock-up. They're looking for the ability to stop him as there's the wish from Bang, but I don't think it's going to be enough. Grey health is there. He's going to eat a Blitzcrank, but that ain't that delicious as Airy finishes it off for Kingzone. BDD uses all of his mana.
Faker walks down.
Well, he's going to jump in as Blank. He's going to get there. Still has the ultimate. Remember, teleport invested by SKT of all teams. Kingzone are moving up, but are they going to get there in time? The answer is no, but Prey, he still wants it. In goes the Rakan, but I don't know whether it's going to be enough. Oh, really good use of the ult from Prey, but it's not going to be enough. Two kills for Faker. SKT rolling over.
Let's crank on the roam.
Yep, Blank is going to get hooked. Another binding comes in as these guys looking like they've been laning together forever. That's going to be Prey getting delivered a kill for free.
And this is, again, the counter side neutral. It was a close one, but was secured by Blank. Bot side neutral going the way of Kingzone, splitting the map in terms of vertical jungle using his W.
Oh, gets the hook and no Arctic Assault available now for Blank because he's going to jump himself in there, but can't. Not going to be able to enter the fight. It's Tal's there, but Blank, he ain't going to be so lucky. Gorilla picks himself up a well-deserved kill on the Blitzcrank.
Man, on his hand, a pretty good turnaround.
Yep, not going to find the E as Faker as BDD does at least throw out the Soul Shackles. The flash is there. Black Shield has been gone through as there's the bind and the hook under the turret. Effort going to eat up Faker, take him away, but this is just going to cost them and cost them. Out of turret in the mid lane is going to go down. SKT investing
a lot. Probably get it. They walk up with it. Yeah, they will be able to secure it on this push.
Yep, unable to take down the eye, so that is going to secure the first turret here for SKT, but it's answering first turret blood going down in the mid lane.
Top for Kingzone bot. The reverse of that is true. They transferred their power topside when we saw the Sejuani go down, the ward coverage. And ward supremacy.
He's got heal and ghost, and he got hooked level one. So
speaking of.
Yep, he's going to get caught once again. I was definitely memeing, but this is definitely a problem.
Is it?
Yeah, as Tal, he's going to come in with the apprehend. May have saved it, but Khan gets delivered a kill. Flashes out, but he's still not going to survive. It's Bang that grabs that kill, but remember, Prey's still alive. And the hook is going to land. Bladecaller will be there very soon. See you later, Darius. As now Bang trying to get himself out. Cuz has a stopwatch though, as Blank's taking so much damage. Prey gets his double kill, and Faker, can he actually get it with the Demon Flare? He can! And the Swain is getting huge now.
Low mana bar on BDD means he can all the way down as some people are coming to assassinate.
Yeah, I feel like he's pretty used to this by now, but it's going to be a tough one. Gets slowed down, gets exhausted. He doesn't have flash, and he is dead. Effort's going to eat him and deliver the kill to the piggy that Blank is riding. All right, Soul Shackle's coming in here from BDD. He's going for the 1v1. Will he have the bind? He
watch
does.
Watch the W, watch the W
damage. The puddle's
damage.
Doing so much work as the wish comes in. Now BDD, he wants another round of spells. Will he have it? The ult, the dunk, it's not enough from BDD. The hook comes in, but there's the 1-2 from Gorilla.
Turn around there with the long cooldowns on the Morgana. Clear to see, and SKT send less members. They walk straight down mid lane. They might just get the turret.
Yep, out of turret, in trouble. Four members here versus the three. The Kingzone have thrown in. Prey has the QSS already picked up, so the ultimate's not going to register, but the tower will still go down.
Man, such a bloodthirsty game with so much engage. Speaking of engage.
Oh yeah, never move coming in as Faker invests the ult into this fight. Featherstorm coming down, but he's so low. Prey! Still going to survive, but the Rakan is dead. Cuz not able to get there. Never move, not enough range. As now the empowered Shock Blaster doing some work. But
that's too good.
Hook's going to register once again onto Effort, who explodes. Prey's going to pick up the kill, and SKT wonder where their Tom Kench.
And CC everywhere. We get a very bloody game. 18 kills in 21 minutes. Got the LPL going on for one game. Thanks for joining. Goes, all right.
Oh, Gorilla. He's going for the style, but the never move is going to land in, and that is a very dead Rakan. We mentioned that it wouldn't take a lot of killing, and it didn't. very quickly a 4v5 as the binding does land. The puddle doing some work as in goes SKT. Okay, that was optimistic. Nevermove lands onto the Blitzcrank as the Wish is doing a bunch of work. Faker explodes in the middle of the fight, and Effort is going to save him. They do get the Tahm Kench, and Prey is still alive. That's a lot of kills for SKT.
Faker's Demon Flare ripped through the team, Tal.
Apprehend, not going to go in there as Khan. He thinks he can take it. The W doing some work, wants another auto, doesn't get it.
Tal got the ganks. That was big. As, speaking of ganks, Tal is going to get crushed here.
Yep, doesn't have flash.
But what about Baron?
I have a feeling he's going to be dead, but you're exactly right. Teleport actually is going to be extremely, are going to rip them apart. Faker, Nevermove's not going to land as they find Morgana before Black Shield, and she is just terrorized by SKT. They are going to get a Rift Scarlet. Prey's going to be able to easily take down this Ocean Drake by himself. They have a monopoly on the dragons this game.
Keep drinking the caffeine, Atlas. I need you to get...
And Gorilla, he wants to get the hook, and he's going to get it. Explosion of damage as Apprehend lands onto Prey, but he doesn't care.
That's the Bonanza.
Yep, Teleport going to come in, but Faker immediately knocked up.
He's dead!
The Zonyas, he's dead! That is so much of the damage out of the fight, and Effort dies as an afterthought. Kingzone will have free reign. He does a fair bit of damage to it. Gorilla will have his passive to keep him alive as well. Kingzone will secure this Baron at 30 minutes into the game.
So... you just evacuate, and Tal says, well, I need to get there, guys. So he's going to recall. They're going to try and regroup. And Kingzone actually take down an inhib. It almost feels like you have to hit a skill shot because Jace Pope, yeah, I want to avoid as well.
Good God, Gorilla is moving fast. Doesn't land the hook, so maybe a window of opportunity here for SKT. Darkbinding also down, but that tower evaporated.
When do you walk up, though? Because if the Blitzcrank hook misses, there could still be a binding. There could still be a Jace Accelerated Shock Blast. There's so much to respect. And pray through all that disarray. Can even get the feathers in and make something happen.
Yeah, just wanders up. And of course, the follow-up CC from him. Prey's going to move up. He's got a Black Shield if he needs it as well. BDD playing support, but also playing destruction because these puddles even have to be respected. He's got bindings everywhere because of all his CDR that he can build with the money that he's managed to accrue. It's not the kind of Morgana's we're used to. As in goes Blank, looking for a desperation play. But gets it on to Khan, but doesn't get much.
Oh,
hook lands on the Tahm Kench, and in goes Kaz. Prey is going to pick up all of these kills. They're golden, but they're just waiting for the inevitable. Double kill comes in for Prey. Make that a triple. He's still looking for more as Kingzone will take down SKT in game one. The flashes from Khan as well, just for the style points, as the hook under the fountain is denied by Bang. He's still going to die, though, as Fake is going to get somehow the kill credit onto Kaz.
That's what happens with the Tahm Kench sometimes. You devour, you give a double kill to the side of Kingzone. Until the end, we didn't know the lane assignments. We didn't know likely Darius' lane counter to the Mundo, but Mundo can also play. That's actually a good cancel. We talked about bad cancels. It allowed Kuz enough time to be there. And now Kuz is here, but he's not full health.
Yep, well, really good use of the cleaver on the right. Target is Tal, can't catch up, but he does flash. Apprehend comes in. That's first blood. He's going to get it with exactly the right part of his axe. And Tal, this is the better start.
Can Camille really help with this?
Well, Khan's not even going to cancel. I thought he was going to, as the taunt is going to come in. The hookshot's good, though, but massive damage under this turret. Faker tanking this one up. I don't know whether they're going to be able to do this without sacrifice. Oh, my God, the minions. As Tal picks up the kill.
Well, pace definitely suits SKT.
That's a 3-0, Darius. Prey's going to get eaten. That's a very aggressive devour, but it's a good flash, a sneaky one, to get him out the wrong side. He's going to have to go on the mad dash to escape this one, as Bang not taking too much damage. He ain't deterred, as Prey does find the arcane shift.
Got it, get the kill.
Yeah, well, Faker, he turns up and... Hello? Winds of War, that's going to do it. Okay, Faker picks it up. It was comical, but they do get it in the end.
Is at 4 minutes.
Yeah.
He just dumpsters it on.
Well, that's dead Khan.
Yep.
Under the turret.
You know?
Oh okay. My God, they're going to jump in. Hero's Entrance will come down onto Tal, though, and they have to kill him if they want this fight. The Devourer is there, but is the Darius going to die in his belly? It's a good two-man taunt from Faker, but now finds himself in amongst four, and he is going to go down. BDD grabs that kill. Tal somehow survives off the back end, but no way he can get alive.
And they could disengage that easy, and the disengage still going on.
Oh,
Tal's
my God,
here.
Yeah, the teleport's going to come in from Tal as Kuz just wipes out Effort. Faker comes in as well.
I don't know about this one, Kuz. I don't know about this one.
All right. Well, Khan does.
They have Shen ultimate.
Yep. Are they actually going to invest it? Good hook shot. The Apprehend's going to get two. Ultimatum coming okay. in there in King Zone. They're going to have three top lane and some possibilities on the turret with them. As well as, you're exactly right, first turret blood going down to King Zone in this trade of turrets.
Shelly's going to get a lot of work done. The game where all the flashes are used, the wall just wins the game straight out. As Khan's actually running at Tal.
Well, he may have started a little bit too early here, but Tal's actually not. He's probably taken too much damage. Oh, that taunt was absolutely amazing on the bank. But Tal does go down into his stopwatch. Khan is going to be able to grab that kill. And Gorilla doesn't care about the passive at this point. King's Drake will be going down. Some information gained with that wall coming in there. But SKT going to have full control of the bottom side. River. That is because
Tal's walk up. He's going to get caught here.
Yep, and he's not going to be able to get out, I don't think, as the ultimatum does come in. Maybe I tell a lie. There's the stopwatch. True Shot Barrage comes in. Cuz still alive somehow, but the flash from Faker is going to seal his death. And a second. That was just biting off more than he could chew. I was about to see
that SKT are most likely looking for the turn. Speaking of turns, Tal on the backside.
Yep, Khan's in here as well, as they do get the pullback onto Gorilla. Taunts his way out as well, as they do try and turn in on this one. Devour's not necessary as the Winds of War pick up the kill, but now can the chase actually come in? The pullback onto Prey, but he's getting a lot of shots across. Teleport from BDD as he's home guarding his way in.
Can the wall
actually grab them? The kill, Justice Punch denied as Prey picks up the kill. And now Blank trying to run away from the briefcases and will be able. Poor man's Weaver's Wall comes in as BDD sets that one up. Baron over to King Zone. They look like geniuses after they just look like idiots.
This game is Atlas in a nutshell, by the way.
Yeah. Oh, God. Craziness going, well, I'll just farm and I'll just get myself to three items and then I'm going to try and win the game. Much like game number one on his Zaya.
Weavers. The Anivia wall is just going to be the most disgusting in this game.
Well, Faker having to deal with Cuz with a newly formed Trinity Force, but he's going to get taunted. There's the ultimatum. Heroic Entrance is interrupted, and he picks up the kill. Cuz is a god. He had the help of Gorilla, of course, with the Stands United. But Faker was.
Turns out if you win, it was calculated, and if you lose, it's hilarious.
Yeah. And really dumb. And why did they do this? Oh, they're so stupid. Otherwise.
As you should. Still plenty. He's got most of the gold. The wall is not going to actually completely stop Maker.
Well, he's just going to stand there and taunt, but they are going to be able to get it. Yep, and not a lot of options. As you can see, SKT just scrambling for any ability to defend these turrets. Looking for an of our lives. So I honestly don't know what could happen. SKT still have that let's...
a third death.
BDD and Prey are on the same page. It's going to be a rough time as Faker throws out the taunt for Justice Punch. Now everything on cooldown. They are going to start this fight. Feels like the kind of fight SKT want. It's Cuz right off to the side. Good wall comes in, but now they're just trying to take down the Mondo. Brilliant never move comes in onto BDD, and he's not getting any damage in here. Blank gets himself out alive as the Darius is going ballistic. It's a double kill already. Make that a triple as BDD has nowhere to run. Good stun comes in as Prey cleans him up, and now can he get the rest of them without the Darius? They just don't have a lot unless they pick off the Ezreal.
The double turnaround.
Now the egg's there, and Faker, he's not scared of no egg. That's a double for the king of the mid lane, and somehow SKT come out on top.
Execution on both.
Cleaver down, or briefcase down this Ocean Drake to even out the Drakes.
Ray went very much into the death.
Remember, they've also got the wall to set up, and this is just theirs. There's decent vision around, but Blank says, okay. Well, I mean, a lot of the money for SKT is stacked on top of Tal, but Adaptive Helm is brilliant in this game.
Gorilla split push.
Oh, he's a classic split push. Oh, that's not the top laner, never mind. Inhibitor does go down, so base is broken, but...
Shen can bring up the minions in the mid lane. The least conventional 1-3-1 ever, as the support and top laner are pushing.
Yep. And,
our expectation, and yet SKT could still buff one, but they trade flashes.
Yep, that is going to be Cuz jumping in there. Heroic Entrance is down. They're trying to keep Tal alive. He survives for a long time, but that flash was questionable at best, and now the sad isn't there for Khan. He ain't dying anytime soon. BDD keeps himself alive in the fight, and I feel like this is King Zone really laying the hammer down on top of SKT. Cuz even able to go into his stopwatch as they're relegated to their fountain. Blank and Faker now just waiting for the inevitable as the 2-0 for Kingzone, the bounce back after the loss against Griffin, is completed. It's another bloodbath, an incredibly fun